in association with Spinks Perfumed Deo for the active you.
Welcome to the evening show at 6. I am Presca in association with Spinks Deo. We bring you this show, and whenever it's Friday, I really think it's my day because I get chance to interact with a lot of different personalities, talk to them and feel whatever is going around Kathmandu. And whenever I say this, I really missed out something yesterday when I was invited to one of this very important gesture, which is an abstract dance drama named as Cafe the Flow. So I would love to know about this, and I was really excited. I couldn't be there, so I have a lot of the curiosity, but I have questions. If I had seen that, maybe I wouldn't question as much as I would question today. I am so glad that I'm calling and inviting both of them. Let me just introduce. Solis performing your Warliota Academy Bonum, where they have this very important gesture that a performing arts related sabai kura haru include garera ke ke huna sakcha bhanne hisab ma nikalnu bhayeko cha ani tes madhye waharu ko first event ma yo first part ma waharle yo introduce garnu bhayeko cha as Cafe the Flow bhanera and Cafe the Flow ko bare ke cha kasto waharu sang kura garna ko lagi I have the one who has thought about it, dreamt about it, and has been performing in Nepal since a very long years. And it's been 2013 when she came to Nepal, so I'm going to ask her more about it, as well as we have the proprietor for the part, and main importantly, jole chai yesma aafno full time lagairanu bhayeko cha. Apart from what he does from reef, from karma, there are so many things associated. And on top, he's very popular because he's just gone to bhakare match hera pani aunu bhayeko cha. We've seen his pictures all over with Liverpool ko aba ahilai ta fan bhaisaknu bhayeko cha. So I'd like to introduce both of them, Rabin Dai and Alize. Welcome to the show, both of you. Thank you so much for coming to the show.
Thank you so much for inviting us.
Could you please tell me something about Solis Performing Arts? Isko lagi ta tapaile, how did you guys come up with this idea? Because last year too, we had a conversation about this as well. How did this begin?
Well, it's basically the friendship we have, actually. That's the important thing, I think. I've known Alize for last four years now. Mm-hmm. So, but in between, we are not in touch for a while because she was busy in her own things and I was busy with my restaurant business. But again, a year and a half back when we met up, then we came up with this idea of doing something about the, especially with the performing arts, with the dance, she knows, acting she does, like, you know, I've always been a fan of hers, actually.
Okay. And then this idea came of Solis Performing Arts.
Yes, I mean, I always had this idea of wanted to have a dance company mixed also with music and theater. Why? Because I couldn't really concentrate on one art form. I love a lot of different art forms, so I really wanted to combine it all together. So we've been discussing, and you've been seeing my work also and what I've been doing here in Nepal and also abroad. And I've told him about my ideas, my thought of really trying to bring a company here and also a school, so that we can really train people from a young age in the world of arts. Mm-hmm. And to be able to train them also in an international level, so that Nepal can be put on a map also for art. And not just thinking, oh, Nepal is a third world country, or, you know, they need some help. Because Nepal has a lot of talent and a lot of potential. So then we thought, okay, we have to come up with a company.
Exactly.
We have to start also creating an academy and a professional dance company, acting company, music company, so that we can really bring the art level in Kathmandu and abroad to another level.
Mm-hmm. That's why Solis existed.
Exists.
Yeah. And from Solis, we have as Cafe the Flow as That's the right. first one, as mm-hmm. the abstract dance drama.
That's right.
What is this about?
So I wanted to go a little bit close to home. Mm-hmm. Now because I'm French, I wanted to bring a little bit of that French vibe and French feel also in Kathmandu. And due to that, because it's something that I'm really connected with, it's, you know, it's my country. All my family really comes from here. So all the little inside and all the little feel that maybe people could have or relationship, I'm really aware of it instead of using maybe a different culture to be able to portray it to a show. So as a first dance drama, I wanted to go completely abstract. Mm-hmm. Because I feel that sometimes we are very you know, different and advertised in the way that we are inside, mm-hmm. you know. We might see something and feel something. Someone else is going to see the same thing and feel something different. But then Nepal reminds me a lot about France many years ago in the way that the way the society is. I can really relate it to when my mom was young also.
Yeah.
And it's still something that I remember. So when I came to Nepal, I felt a lot of things were really connected. So I thought, okay, let me bring it to the show. So the show Café de Flore is actually based in 1950, 1960, in Paris itself, in a cafe. And now in a cafe, you have a lot of different type of people. You have a lot of different things that happens. And I wanted to portray the thing that people can see, but also the people, the thing that people hide inside themselves, you know?
Right.
In the fact that, for example, I'll just give you one example. you know, you might see a man who is a big gentleman, very polite, because that society makes him like that. And he has to act that way to be able to also be respected. But then maybe deep inside him, he has an animal side that wants to burst out. Or, you know, he's maybe very shy. Or, you know, there might be a lot of ego, a lot of anger from inside that may be hidden that he will never let out. But maybe only on the closed door, only with his wife. Or only with his parents, or only with his children. So I wanted to bring out all the different aspects of life and of people that are sometimes hidden. So okay. This show is really about the communication and the connection with people, and how people sometimes use it. So using flattering, humiliation, bitching, all the really strong and extreme force, I would say, of a relationship.
So it's a mix of expressions that one can do.
That's right.
Well, I would love to ask, because Rabin Dai has already watched it. As a provider, it's different because you are doing it.
Yeah,
but
exactly.
As an audience, it's a different feeling.
It is. I didn't want to watch all those rehearsals time because I wanted to watch the whole show. I mean, like, and yesterday it happened. And like, when I watched it, I was like, speechless. It was really, I mean, as I said, it's not because it's my, it's our show, but like, as a, me being a little bit of
audience
and a little bit of like drama lover, like a little bit of acting lover. So I just loved it so much. Like the expressions, the actors, the expressions they have given, the whole show. I mean, like, as she said, like, you know, when she approached me with this storyline, like when she said, like, let's do the, came up with this storyline, I said, like, I had like, suddenly I said, like, okay, let's do it, like, you know. Mm-hmm. I didn't even think twice about it, because it was such a, it is a portrayal of all the different kind of, like, you know, feelings and all this of the human being. So I said, like, let's do it. And like, when I watched it yesterday, wow, like, it is international. That's what I was saying. Like, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, like, it might be, as I said, it's a little bit abstract. It's not a regular show you will be seeing in town.
Yeah.
You know, like, it might be, sometimes you might feel like, okay, what is going on, kind of thing. But again, at the end, like, you will see that beautiful ending of the show, so I'm sure everybody will enjoy it.
We'll definitely enjoy it, and it's starting right here from today for 2 weekends. So it's going to be 16th, 17th and 18th of Feb this week, and next week it's going to be 23rd, 24th and 25th. You can get tickets at Calm, at Tamarind, at Reef.
And 25 hours.
And 25 hours itself, because it's happening in the 25 hours. And that closed door would give you a different experience for sure by Café de Flore. As I say this, let's enjoy this wonderful song, and we'll be right back at the evening show at 6. Welcome back to the show again. Purnakshi Swadhan, a chance of the evening show at 6. Mahununsa, we're talking about Café de Flore. This is an abstract drama dance which is happening for 2 weekends. If you're not going to go this weekend, next weekend it's going to happen too. But don't forget, it's just for 2 weekends, but you know, you can get tickets. So please do get tickets before go. Is there on like door sale as well?
Also.
Yes.
Also? So if you are like not free enough to take the tickets early, you can just go for the door sale as well. But except the Café de Flore, because it already began for you since a very long time here, and since 2011 you've been doing a lot of different shows as well. How did it really start here in Nepal, and how did you think that you want to stay back?
So actually, my first idea of coming to Nepal was supposed to be only for 1 year, more just to see a different side, different country also, and be able to travel a little bit. I wanted to do a little bit of research for shows and programs that I was planning to do later. Mm-hmm. But then when I arrived here, I met Deborah Morelli, mm-hmm. who is a theater director mm-hmm. from America. And she offered me, actually, the lead role in her new play. So then I started to meet a little bit new artists and new actors and new dancers here in Nepal. And I felt that it, you know, it's really a place where I could feel that I could also grow as a director. And there were so many people that were not able to get training in Nepal, mm-hmm. if it's in a dance or even in drama. So they were really learning to learn and to be able to express their passion also and to be able to explore their own self as Nepali artists. Mm-hmm. So I would say it would be the Nepalese that touched me and made me stay here.
Oh, that's really nice. Welcoming to Rabin Bhai, doing from all the restaurant business to reef entertainment to Solis. You've been doing a lot of things, you know. How did you, like, how did it just happen? I know it hola, kati sunye hola, but officially or just where did that start come from?
Well, I mean, the restaurant things happened, started like when I came back from Singapore after my studies and all those things. So I had a couple of my friends who were also interested in restaurant business and hotel business. So that was the time we started. We thought of doing restaurants, and I was also doing a little restaurant thing while I was in Singapore. So I had this idea. So I thought, like, let's come up with something different in Nepal. So that's how Reef started. So after running for last 3.5 years, we started a club called Karma. Again, that was, it was kind of addiction for me now, like, you know. So I was so, because it was good, the best part about it is, like, you get to meet a lot of different kind of people, like, you know. And that's, and you meet everybody in the same place. So that's what I wanted to grow, like, you know. Like, why not? Like, expand it, like, you know, different ways, and so that I can meet more people. And so I think that is the point. There was this point, like, where I said, like, okay, now, I mean, because I've always been into music and arts and all these things. I've grown up I had a band and all these things. So I said, like, again, when we met up and we thought, like, all right, so she was into arts and I was into a little bit of music and arts kind of things. So, like, all right, when a lot of things, we used to dance together, like, you know.
I think he was missing art.
Yeah. So I love salsa and all this. So whenever we used to meet, we do a little dance on the stairs and all. So I was like, all right, if we click, means, I mean, like, why not? Like, we do something together. Mm-hmm. You know, she was thinking of doing something. And at the same time, I was growing up in a different level again, like, you know, because I've always wanted me to be busy all the time. I love to keep myself busy. So that's like, okay, why not? So that's how Solis started, and that's how Cafe de Flore came up, actually.
All right. Also, can you please share us a little experience about your Liverpool experience?
Wow, that was a wow moment. I mean, that's seriously. I mean, to get a chance to go to Liverpool and watch in the Anfield Stadium was already a big thing. So I would like to thank Carlsberg for that one, actually, who really came up with this idea, and I was the lucky one to go over there. Among also with another two friends. And on top of that, when I got a chance to award the Man of the Match award to Mohamed Salah, like, I would say, like, the best player at the moment, the football player. I'm sure, like, all the football fans would know about it. And, like, I was never a Liverpool fan, very honestly. I'm going to tell you in the television. But after watching that show, like, after being there in Liverpool and being Anfield Stadium, I'm a big fan of Liverpool now, so like I follow Liverpool games, like, you know, and like I follow Mohamed Salah, whom I gave award from my own hand.
Oh my god!
I mean, like, as I said, like, you know, like the next day when I met some Liverpool fans, or they're like, they didn't even like, you know, they were like shocked. They didn't even like believe, like, you know, like I gave that award to him. So they thought it was a Photoshop picture, and I showed them videos. The live videos, they were like, they said, like, wow, that is like something we would dream about it, like, you know.
Yeah.
So that was the experience. I was.
It was moment.
Amazing.
That's like you'll never forget in your
Definitely
life ever.
Not. That is lifetime experience, I would say.
And actually, all the Liverpool fans are like jealous, looking at Rabin Bhai's pictures, and then your Instagram everywhere. You're like, you click that picture with Mohamed, and that too. It might be Photoshopped. Would be the first question they.
Yeah, no, exactly.
Of course,
exactly.
They will ask. Well, for now, it's time we're taking a short little break again. We'll be right back talking more about it. We are right here at the Evening Show at 6 in association with Sphinx Studio. Welcome back to the show again, and welcoming you back. I was just trying to explain that I really like the show. Kinavane, we get so much of like a lot of chance that we can talk to different artists, their creation, get inspired from them, and it's really great to know about something like this. And I have both interest in theater and dance. And asking about Cafe de Flore, like how many artists are involved in it?
So altogether, we have 11 artists on stage. Mm-hmm. Now, I would say all the artists are very dominant in a way, because it's not like we have a chorus and then just some leads. Every artist has something very individual that they are bringing. And I think all of them are shown into a different light. Mm-hmm. What do you think?
Yeah, did you feel the same? Yes.
Yeah, I did. So.
Where they all portray different characters, so of course they're not portraying the same thing, but I wanted to bring out really something different and beautiful from each of them, so that it's not really like the traditional show where we have the two or three lead, mm-hmm. and then everyone is part of the chorus. So in that part is really about we are all kind of the same. Mm-hmm. So there's a lot of a hidden message actually in that show. That maybe not everyone will get, or maybe everyone will get in slightly different ways, and that is also okay. And that's the main point about being abstract.
Yeah.
Because it's for you to make your own opinion and your own understanding about what you see and what it is also.
Yeah. So, how
I mean, like, yeah, I mean, like, when I saw it as an audience, like, I felt like everyone was lead actors out there, like, you know, so there was like, everyone had their own stories, and they had a chance to share their stories. Yeah. Every individual, 11 of them had different characters, they were, as I would say, like, in every scene you would see them as, every individual were lead actors out there. There was no hero or heroine kind of thing, like, you know, so that is the beauty about it. And I had a couple of friends who were watching the show yesterday with me, who were not into drama at all, but they were like, they were like, you know, like are these all Nepalese, like, except like Siyoung and Alize. Siyoung is another friend of ours who is Korean actor, and she's from France, so it's more of a multi-international show kind of thing, I would say. So all the rest of them were Nepalese, but like the dialogue deliveries they were doing, the actings, it was that's the reason I said it was international kind of thing, because for even from my friend, they were like, I'm sure they're not Nepalese, like they're like, there are some artists from foreign countries. So that was, I think, the best part about it, the strong vibes, the strong energy of that one.
And how long did it take for you to create? And
so the creation part, so I always work on my own, working on the script and, you know, just try to find the essence of what I want to bring. But then also, I had a workshop with all of the actors and all of the dancers, because I wanted to bring them to a different level, to somewhere else where they've never been. I wanted them to be able to explore themselves, not just like they normally will have. They normally have a script,
and they
read the script, you learn the line, and you work on the director on how you're gonna set the line or how the character is. But this time was very different, because every dialogue, every monologue is much more personal, and it's much more connecting to deep emotion. It can be either happy, it can be either sadness, it can be either more towards anger or frustration. So that are the three main base of the emotion in acting. Mm-hmm. Now, due to that, I really worked with them by changing their way of working completely. In the way that they've ever worked before. So we did about 3.5 weeks of really deep inner workshop to be able to work on their international emotion and international connection also with their own body. Because the actors, I'm making them dance, and the dancers, I'm turning them into actors.
That's the best part.
Oh,
I
mean, my gosh.
Among them, you are like dancers, and they're not actors at all. Uh-huh. And like, she made them actors. I was like, okay, like, you know, like.
And they never acted before. So for them, it was is the first time that they're acting. Mm-hmm. But when you see them on stage, you feel that they've acted before. It doesn't feel like it was the first show. Mm-hmm. It doesn't feel like an amateur show.
Okay.
And due to the process and how we work together, I was really able to explore with them from inside. And I think also for them, it makes them grow a lot as an artist, because it makes them understand more. And that's what I said to them. Even if you're just walking on stage, you need a purpose. You cannot just walk to walk, you know? You cannot just say a word to say the word. Mm. You need to be connected to that. And then if you're connected to that, then that also portrays something else to the audience. So we really went through a different method of working. And it was really beautiful.
It is.
Actually,
it's
really beautiful. And
it sounds beautiful.
You definitely need to come and watch the
will,
show.
I will. I really like theater and I'd come and definitely watch the show too. For now, let's enjoy another musical break. We'll be right back.
In association with Spinks Perfumed Dio for the active you.
As I welcome you back, I know this is the last part and we have like few more minutes to go. But before that, few things of why the public should not miss it at all. Like Cafe de Flore should not be missed. For what reasons do you think?
First thing, it's I would say like something very different for Nepali theater world, Nepali drama world, I would say. And if you want to have that international kind of feeling, international Bye. Show kind of thing in Nepal, so this is the right show, I would say.
Okay.
So that's one of the reason. And second thing is like people, this connection, as you, this mix of dance and drama. So people who are into dance can also enjoy, and people who are into drama they can also enjoy. So I think if they can see both connected, that's another beautiful part about it. That's a different level actually. So I think people shouldn't miss for that reasons. Yeah.
And plus also it's a different way of doing a show due to the intimate place. It even feels a little bit like a cabaret, you know, type of show, where you feel that you are actually in Paris in a cabaret watching a show. So the like Rabin said, you know, it's more in an international level in a sense where the type of show you will have it anywhere around the world. And sometimes in Nepal, you know, we have a little bit of lack of that. I have many of my friends, especially expat or even Nepali friends, that are saying to me, we love Kathmandu, but there's not enough entertainment because Kathmandu is the main, you know, is the capital also. So that's what we want to do with Solis. We want to be able to bring that international level of show, and also very different than any other company, any other theaters in Nepal, any other dance program, and being able to rise that level so that people don't think, oh, I have to fly to Dubai or I have to go to Bangkok to be able to see this camera show. They can also have it in their own country, in their own city.
Oh, that really sounds good. And if Solis Performing Arts would definitely do something in the future, like whether it be about art of anything else, like not just drama, theater or dance, but it would also be music, you said, paintings, anything that. All right. Is it going to happen? Any future plans to it?
Yes.
Yes.
So we have already, even for next year, we have two amazing light and stage designer, and also an amazing costume designer from Russia. They want to come, and I'm already working with them on the new big show for 2019. Otherwise, in 2018, we are planning to have at least three or four big shows per year. So the coming one is going to be a musical show.
Yeah, so let's not
reveal it.
It's going to be something international. It's going to be a big deal.
And as you said, it's also like an academy where people can learn. So how would we get a chance to learn? That's like for my personal interest. What if I want to like join into some dance forms, or how would it be possible?
So for me right now, due to the company that we have, so the company members, I'm also training them to teach. Okay. So that also in the academy, they also are able to teach. So then we will have dance and drama mainly at the beginning. Right now, we are still looking for the perfect location.
Yeah, we have small space right now.
Right now, we have a small space. So we haven't advertised it more because I want to keep more the company right now. And then when everything is set up, then we'll open it more to the public.
Okay.
So I know we have a lot of demand.
lot of demand already. Anyways, so thank you so much, both of you, for coming to the show.
Thank you very much.
It would be great to see Cafe de Flore, and I'm going to definitely be there. You definitely be there for two different weekends, this weekend and the next weekend. To watch out at 25 hours, you can buy tickets as well. well, or you can just rely on the door sale and you might not get it too. So before that, do get the tickets. And both of you, thank you so much for coming to the show.
Thank you very much, Presca.
Thank you. With this, it's time I, Presca, take a leave as well. I'm going to catch you with more shows this week. Until then, we three are going to say bye for now. So it's bye-bye from us. Much love. Mwah.
In association with Spinks Perfumed Deo for the active you.